That's what needs to happen.
A verdict tonight for a former pageant official accused of molesting a young girl. Pickens County jury found Joey Sanders guilty today of committing a lewd act on a girl between 2005 and 2008.
That verdict came down about 3.5 hours after deliberations started this afternoon. News 4's John Eby was in the courtroom before the verdict and joins us now from our Greenville newsroom. And John, he wasn't found guilty on all the charges, right?
That's right. Sanders was found guilty of committing a lewd act on a minor, but acquitted on the more serious charge of second-degree criminal sexual conduct. It came after a long day of detailed and graphic testimony, including some from Sanders himself. Sanders took the stand to say that not only did he not have sex with the victim, but that he couldn't have sex at all because of erectile dysfunction.
It's never gotten any better. It doesn't work, period. I mean, it's not here today, gone tomorrow. It's the same all the time.
But then his ex-wife took the stand to say the opposite. Veronica Gay Hubbard testified that she separated from Sanders in fall of 2005, and up until about May of that same year, she said they were sexually active.
Did you have sexual intercourse with him in 2005?
Yes.
How often?
Not as often, but at least once every 2 weeks.
Okay. And was he capable at that time?
Yes.
Okay. Did he get an erection?
Yes.
The victim claimed that Sanders not only had sex with her, but that he repeatedly violated her with his hands. In the end, that may have been enough for the jury to find him guilty of committing a lewd act.
As the charge of lewd act upon a child, we, the jury, unanimously find defendant Joseph Pedro Sanders IV guilty.
Sanders' girlfriend, Anita Gearhart, was also found guilty of unlawful conduct toward a child for knowing about the abuse, but doing nothing about it.
I'm sure she's disappointed. You know, the system works.
Gearhart testified that the victim had lied about other things and that when she questioned Sanders about the abuse, he denied it. Afterward, Assistant Solicitor Doug Richardson says he was pleased with the jury's decision, even though Sanders was not found guilty on every charge.
Are you disappointed with the split decision at all?
Not really. He's going to jail, and that's what needs to happen.
But according to a written statement from the victim read after the verdict, even though Sanders may go to prison, the damage can't be undone.
I do not trust people like I once did. I'm always looking over my shoulder to make sure no one wants to harm me.
And Sanders and Gearhart were not sentenced tonight. They'll be back in court tomorrow morning. The maximum penalty for the charge against Sanders is 15 years in prison. John Eby, WYFF, News 4, live in the Greenville newsroom.